The idea is to use this traceit function to build your own interactive debugger. We're going to call this my-spyder for my simple Python debugger, with the idea of a spider being something that catches all the bugs. My-spyder is a super simple debugger, as it says in the name. My-spyder is a command line debugger, so it prompts you to enter a command, and a command can be something like break in line 70, run the program, and when it reaches line 70, it stops. And as it has stopped, we can print individual variables, for instance, x, and x, say, has a value of 42. How do we do that? We need a number of variables that control how the debugger works. First, a variable named stepping, which tells us whether we are stepping line by line through the program or whether we're just running the program. We also have a list of breakpoints. Actually, it's a mapping of individual line numbers to arbitrary values. But if this mapping, say, has an entry for the number 7, this means that whenever the debugger reaches line 7, then execution should stop. For our current setting, we'll make our life simple. We'll have a number of predefined breakpoints. We will have, for instance, a breakpoint in line 9. And possibly another one in line 14. Our traceit function is being called for every single line. And of course, we want our debugger to stop whenever either a breakpoint is reached or when we're stepping from one line to the next. We want to access these global variables, so we need to declare them accordingly. If the event is that we reached a new line, we check if we're stepping or if our breakpoints dictionary has a value for the current line. And if this actually is the case, we print out appropriate diagnostic information, which may be helpful for the debugger, what has happened, where we currently are, the function that's executed, as well as the local variables.